From She's a Sassy Lady. And today I have so many things to share with you. I'm just so excited. I have had so many people write me, call me, ask me in person, how do you put together a card party? Well, that's what today is going to be like. Now, I just got back from a card party, and look at this. These are all the cards, which I'm going to show you in another video. But this is what we do to prepare for a card party. The first thing I do is I design these card parties. I design basically because I wanted to get together with friends that would like to create like I do. And the whole purpose is to have fun, to sit and talk and create cards. Now, the cards, of course, you can't start out from scratch because you'll be sitting there looking at each other and not get anything done. So each participant at the card party has to do work before they come. First, what happens is they get an email invitation. The name of our group is the Designing Dixie Darlings. And we just met Sunday and had our card party. This is Monday, and I'm doing this video, and I don't know how long I have before I'm going to be able to get it up, but we'll see how fast I can actually move. At any rate, I just take pictures of some past parties, and I put on there, and I tell them that we're going to have another card party, and I hope that they can design their cards, and they can come, and that there's only 8 seats available. And the reason why I have 8 seats is my house, and this is the card party, is being hosted by my daughter, and I'm the co-host this time. Usually I'm the host and she's the co-host, but we work it together because it's hard to do everything. Jennifer was the hostess, I was the co-hostess, so everything was at her house. She had enough seating for 8 people. At Maymay made its house, we had, Amy had a room for 10 people, and we had 10 people at the card party. So it depends on how large your home is and how much space your dining room or kitchen, or if you have a basement or whatever, can accommodate all of us ladies. And what everyone does is they prepare 2 card kits, and this first they get invited, and it tells them what they have to do, okay? And then once they have said, I'm coming to the card party, they get a letter of acceptance. Now, the letter of acceptance tells them they're going to have a great time. And there's 8 seats, therefore they are to bring 8 card packets, 2 sets of 8 card packets, or 2 different types of cards, 8 each, for the ladies to make. Now, they must also bring a card that is already made up, so that when we get to making the card, we have, and I know I've got one in here, I don't know if I can put up my hands on it real quick. It's green, so I should be able to. Okay, I would then, on this card happens to be a simple one that I tried printing on the silhouette for the first time. And they will see the card, they'll see what it looks like, and on the inside it says, Lemonade Crunchy Ice Time with You is always nice. But when you get the card packet, they're in all little pieces. Everything's cut, and in the card packet there's an envelope also that they can put the card in, and all the pieces, and what they do is they put together the piece. Now, this is what we call an easy card because there's only a couple pieces. They have to put foam tape underneath the little mice so that it lifts them up a little bit. And when we have what we call a simple card, we call it a contest card. Now, the hostess and co-hostess of the party puts together prizes, and usually the prizes and I'm going to show you one. This is a paper pad, and I got one at the last party, and I got one at this party, and it might be that you're getting adhesive, or just anything that you want to get for prizes. And we allow 1 prize per person at the party, so at least everyone walks away with 1 prize. So that's how it's set up. So now she gets her acceptance letter, and her acceptance letter, it tells her you've got to prepare all these little packets, and in that preparation includes, and I want to put this, the preparation includes Apex will contain the same card and envelope. The colors may vary because you don't always have enough in the stack to do that. You will always have the card stock scored, stamped, images already on the paper, and if they have to be colored in, that must be done also. If they are to be put through the cuddle bug, you have to do that, or the Sizzix, whatever you have. Any embellishments have to put in there, and I brought, this was one in one of my bags, this set of embellishment, and I had some left over from another card, and I just chose the smaller pearls instead of what I, you know, was given. This was given in the card packet, but you put the any embellishments, anything, pop dots, rhinestones. I mean, if pop dots are needed, you really, example, a regular pop dot, everyone has pop dots, everyone has foam tape, but what you don't have is, like, if you're doing a slider card, you have to have a specific size of pop dot. Well, then you should provide that in the card packet. And you will be, at the time, I put all the cards, or all the card packets, each one that comes in has an envelope, a plastic envelope, and I put their cards in there. And as the host or hostess, that person would then hand out and say, okay, this card is next, and you kind of mix them up so you're not getting everyone's cards or everybody's cards at the same time, you know. And she will then have 10 or 15 minutes. During that time, she'll answer any questions about her card. And we had one Sunday. We had two of them. Laura, unbelievable. She started out as a novice card maker. And now when she brings a card in, we are all baffled. She does such a wonderful, wonderful job. And you'll see when we get to her card, you'll be absolutely amazed that she started out 2 years ago making her first card. And now she makes the best cards that are in there. And so you have to have your 8 envelopes plus a completed card. And what I do is I always take and I put the completed card in my front pocket and put all the envelopes inside, zip it up, and that way I don't have to worry about it. So, and then I use my own envelope to stuff it and, you know, have it all done. And the packets have to be turned in a week before the party date. And here they could take it either to my daughter, Jennifer, or myself. And their packet had to be turned in a week ahead of time. If their packet was turned in, then if an emergency happened, and we had one lady, her grandma got taken to the hospital. You know, we had one lady that came down with the flu hours before the party. Well, her card was there, so we packaged all of her cards that she would make, and all I did was make a photocopy of every single card, send it in her envelope with all the cards in it, and she made her packets, so she still went home, or had 16 cards delivered to her home. Now, how nice is that? You gotta love it. You gotta give some guarantee for the ladies. If they're gonna turn their packets in ahead of time, they are guaranteed to get a card packet from every one of the ladies at the group. 2 card packets. So I'm gonna actually put these on where you can. I'm gonna scan them without our phone numbers on it, and because I'm sure my daughter wouldn't like phone calls during the day at all, asking questions because she works all night long. Me, I'm retired, so it doesn't much matter. If you want to call me, you want to call me. If you have any further questions, hit the contact button on there. Now, the last card or the last email that I send them is, time is winding down. How are you doing with your cards? And I do that to remind them, and I do it about 2 weeks before the party. And I do that so that everyone, and I go over the instructions, the same instructions, and I remind them that they have to bring those completed cards in and get them in to be guaranteed that they are going to get their set of cards no matter what, even if they come in sick. But I remind them because, you know what? People forget, and they think that they still have more and more time, and they don't. And I tell them, it's 2 weeks ahead of time. It's a week before the cards are even due to be turned in, and I had 6 card packets already turned in. 6 different card packets. How nice was that? People love the card party once you start going. And the wonderful, wonderful thing is no one sells anything. We sell absolutely nothing at the card party. However, if we have something new, we take it in and we share and tell them about it. As an example, I had a silhouette. None of the ladies in the group had a silhouette. They all had crickets. I have a silhouette portrait. And all of them were excited about all the cards I had sent. And so I said, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Don't get all excited because I want you to see what the Cricut Explorer does. Because I just got my Cricut Explorer. And the night before the party, I cut out two cards and I made errors on them and everything. And I can show you my cards and I'll even tell you the errors. But I picked out one that would write so that they could see that it would actually write. And I didn't even know that it scored. And so I didn't take the pen out and see how I've got the gray line there. And so, you know, it's just, I didn't know. So I just showed them that just look at how clean these cuts are. They're absolutely perfect. And I said, you know what? I really love, 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 love my Cricut. And now that I have the Cricut Explorer, I couldn't be happier. And after you, I've got about 10 videos that I have made in the past couple weeks. And I've just got to, I spent the day editing today. And I've got to edit some more and take some more pictures. But there's lots of videos coming up on the horizon. And you will be seeing them. And in the meantime, I'm busy trying to learn how to work Design Studio, and I'm all excited about my new Cricut Explorer, and it is wonderful. If you don't have one, do get it. And I just heard today that September 22nd, which is a week from now, we will be getting a print and cut feature will be ready. So, at any rate, that's ready. So now what I want to do is now that I've shared with you how you can do oh, and games. We also do games. In the past, I've done games like if as they're pulling out the cards, sometimes you have seven cards all the same way, and then there's an eighth card with a different color paper. And if the person that picks out the odd color paper, they get a small treat or something like that. And we also have gift bags and treats, and the hostess makes like this was, and I'll have to share a picture because I didn't think of you guys ahead of time. I'm sorry, I could lie to you and tell you otherwise. Hubby and I ate the whole bag of candy that came with this. The two of us ate it all day today. We were little piggies. And this is a purse topper, and then my daughter Jennifer took a plastic bag. I gave her the plastic bags. She wanted to do the rest of it. Since I made this part, she wanted to do the rest. And she took little plastic bags and filled it with all kinds of candy. And it was so wonderful. And so they looked like little purses sitting on the table. And every single person had a little purse. And I mean, I've done things like we've had the Elmo. We've had the Cookie Monster. I did the Sassy Lady one time, and everyone had candy sitting there from the Sassy Lady. We've done big gifts, little gifts. We've had little treat boxes like this filled, and I think this is one that I got, and it's filled with. So it's not. It doesn't cost a lot of money. But it is, it does take some time because you make it ahead of time, your host and co-host, and it's a lot of work. No ifs, ands, or buts, but I want to tell you, we have grown so close, all of us ladies, and absolutely, absolutely love our time together. And we've already scheduled for November, and us ladies are going to do a tag swap for November along with our cards. But the tags will already be made up ahead of time. We'll swap them. Now, another thing that we do is we have it on a Sunday afternoon. We used to do it in the evening, but it became too much. So on Sunday afternoon, we start at 3 o'clock, and each lady brings something. The host and co-host make a meal. And they make a light meal, usually a salad and sandwiches, or Jenny made a homemade Wonderful, wonderful homemade potato soup, and I made a huge salad, and then we had things like cheese and sausage and crackers. We had Philadelphia cream cheese with the pepper jelly over the top of it. We had chicken and little tart things. Oh, they were so good. Anita brought those, and then Abby brought a coconut cake, and Angie brought brownies, and Laura brought a strawberry cheesecake. Amy brought some snackies too. I mean, she had peanut butter cookies and some parfait things that stand up that you just die eating. It just kind of melts in your mouth. And we just had we had hummus. It was just wonderful, and we ate like little piggies and French bread and everything. So you got to have your food, and we take the break with the snacky food first after, you know, 8 cards or 6, 7 cards. Everyone wants to get up and stretch their legs, and we get up and we snack and chit-chat, you know. And then we wait until about 6 o'clock. We have dinner. And then we go back to our card making, and then we go, and after that we have dessert, and then we're done for the evening when we finish our last card. But at any rate, let me show you this. This is unbelievable, the cards that I have here to share with you. And I'm going to leave the envelopes in, except for the one 5x7 black one, because it matches the card. But I do that because I keep my envelopes separate. And I think I might have them all now. No, got another card. Got another card. And another card. And we got all the cards. Okay. This one you already saw. This one you saw. This is the gorgeous, gorgeous, and I have to say, absolutely gorgeous little mice. I just love them. And there was my card that I made with everyone. And I'm going to zoom in on this a little bit so that we can see basically the card. This is the card that I made with everyone. And then this was the one that I brought to show. And this we kind of set in the center of the table so everyone can grab it and look at it as they're making. Okay? This was made by Angie. Is this a unique card or what? Look at this. I had the hardest time with this. And when you open it up, look at this, how it opens up. And you're not going to believe this. She cut this all by hand. This is not done on a machine. She cut it by hand. Can you believe it? Now I've got to move these cards aside so you can see how this goes together. You just keep folding one on top of the other all the way around. Okay. And it fits in an A2 envelope. And there you have your card. Is that adorable or what? Look at that. You know what it reminds me of? Those little things that we used to fold up when we were in grade school. I just aged myself. This is one of my cards, and I love it. And I adjusted it at the card party. I mailed out the one that I used for the card party to a friend of mine that has cancer. And I mailed that out to her today. And but when we were at the card party, when we were making this, Amy, May made it, stuck flowers on the inside too. How cute is that? So of course I used my leftover flowers and put cards on the inside. But this is a stamp of life stamp. It says, when life gets too hard to stand, kneel and pray, trust God. So I sent that out today. Okay, this is my friend Anita. And Anita, don't you just love the card, the color she made for this card? The gray and the yellow, the different shades of gray, always thinking of you. Isn't that awesome? And wonderful note friendship card. This is Anita's daughter made this. And this is a matching birthday card and tag. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. Birthday card and tag, and it matches, so you can put this inside the gift and you can tie this on the outside. And you've got to see this. Look at this. Look at how, isn't that awesome? And she had to run through a crimper, because this one she ran through, used the Swiss dots on that. Next card is from Amy. May made it. And she says she loves doors. And this is a door. Isn't that gorgeous? We ended up with two Christmas cards. Amy did one of them. And it's so cute. Look at the little tiny pearls on it. It was perfect. May holiday magic fill your home. And she said that was from close to my heart. Then I made this card. And hopefully this is the one that's put together. And it's not. This is one of the card packets. I had to make an envelope. When you don't have an envelope that fits, we might as well go back to instructions on the card party. When you don't have an envelope that fits, you have to make an envelope. And see how I put it in the inside is the little flower that gets put on the outside. So that's that. And I'll show you the card that's made. That goes with my unmade cards. I actually have a box of cut cards ready to assemble. And this is what it looks like done. Isn't that gorgeous? It's just beautiful. I'm trying to figure out what's in my light that's making lines across. It's dark upstairs here now. Hubby's at a board meeting, and I'm here doing the video because I'm so far behind in posting and that. We've just been traveling everywhere since I retired. And here's another one of the tops. I always save something so that I can share what we do at the card party. And let's see. This is one of my daughter Jennifer's cards. And she left it open. Now, you got to know a little bit of something about Alabama. They are like absolutely nuts about football. And so she made this so that they can do whatever they want, send it to whoever they want. But you've got to see the football itself. I'm trying to get the light to catch it. And we put it through the cuddle bug. Or she put it through the cuddle bug. Listen to me. She put it through the cuddle bug. And it looks gorgeous. So now here's one of mine. One was one that I showed and one I made. Because remember, when you go there and you have eight packets and there's eight people, you have the one you showed, but you also have another card. So that's why I've got two of them up here. But this was cut from the Silhouette, and I love the fact that how this just cut. You know, and then what amazed me is when I cut on my new Cricut, my brand new Cricut Explorer, oh my goodness, these machines are just unbelievable to what they do. I just love I love both the portrait and the portraits for little papers and the Explorer. Oh, I can't wait to start scrapbooking what I'll be able to do with that. It's just amazing. This I made, and I have to say at the card party, Abby added little freckles on its cheeks. How do you like that? So, of course, I had to add little freckles on. This is the one that I brought and the one that I made. And I had to add freckles on both of them because it looks so much cuter. Aren't they just adorable? And I took a piece of artwork that they had at the Silhouette that all it was the ladybug. And I did what you do at the Cricut, you know. And you guys know how to do this. You take whatever image that you want and double it up. And it causes a little fold, and you make another one the exact size, set it on top, and you've got a beautiful, beautiful card. And look at that. How cute is that? And the inside, you got to love it. Your thoughtfulness hit the spot. Thank you. A thank you card. Who would think a thank you card is that? You know that's going to sit on someone's mantle. When they get that, they're going to love it. Now, I am going to show you, let's see, one of Laura's cards. Remember I told you Laura is just, she's just going gangbusters, and she's doing these gorgeous cards. Look at this. Who would have ever thought? This is a paper bag. She got the idea on Pinterest and duplicated. Now, this is a lady that is not a card maker. And look at this. She bought the mustaches at Michael's. She bought the flowers at Michael's. But then she had some buttons at home and put the button inside the flower. And she said they were all on sale. And then the paper she cut to fit. This is a paper bag. It's got a little pocket in there. She stamped it a special day for a special person. Now, I'm saving this card for my husband for his birthday. Isn't this nice? Look at this. Then you pull out this, and look what it says. Happy birthday. Isn't this card absolutely gorgeous? 2 years ago, a novice card maker and does not own a machine, does not own one at all. So kudos to you. I mean, I am just amazed at what you did with that, Laura. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now here's another new card maker, and this is my friend Dorothy, and Dorothy came over to my house, and she used my machine because she doesn't have one, and she used my machine and cut out her cards. Now this looks like an apple. It looks like for something for school, and guess what she puts in it? A prayer of David. Keep me as the apple of your eye, and that's Psalm 17:8. Don't you love it? Now, how nice is that to send to someone for friendship or someone that's sick and recovering and you've been sending them, especially cancer patients? Let me tell you, ladies, gentlemen, whoever's watching this, if you have a friend that has cancer, just keep sending them cards because they need the encouragement. They really, really need the encouragement. What's this? Oh, I think this is my made one that I thought was made. Yeah, that's made. Okay. This is one of my cards, and I have to tell you a little story about this card. This one, my daughter Jennifer was looking, and I'll show her card next so you'll understand. She was looking for a pop-up card, and she's explaining, and I said, well, I've got one, but it's got all kinds of flowers and that on it. She said, well, that sounds okay. Go ahead. And Jenny had been working overtime. So I cut this card out. This is an accident card. It wasn't supposed to happen. I cut this inside out. Look at this. Can you believe this? Isn't this gorgeous? Look at how that light just hits that. It's a wedding cake. So I cut the inside out, and I've got all of these cut out. And she says, oh, I don't like that. I don't want that. So me, I'm not going to throw out all this stuff. So I just took and made Mr. and Mrs. on the front, and I have wedding cards, and everyone loved it. And they were counting dibs for whose weddings they go to. Now I'm going to show you Jennifer's card that she actually did make. And look at this. Is this cute or what? I have an extra piece of glue hitting over on the other side. She has nothing on the front, so you have no idea what it is. It's a birthday card. Or you could use it as a Christmas card. But I'm going to use it as a birthday card. Is that adorable or what? And she hand did it. She did not use a machine on this. Jennifer's got a Cricut. Didn't even use a machine. Isn't that awesome? Oh, and by the way, this is something that I gave each of the ladies. I gave them a bookmark, and the bookmark says, don't worry about tomorrow. God is already there. And everyone got a bookmark, and you need to know all of us ladies are church ladies. We all go to the same church except Amy, because she lives in another town and she goes to a different church. And so Amy did that one. Then we have this card. This is made by someone that has 6 months been making cards. Now, isn't this adorable? Look at this. Again, this is Angie's card, and she's got a Cricut, hasn't used it yet, and she made this by hand, and she cut all the edges, put some buttons, and look at the little scarf. Can you stand it? Isn't that cute? And these are sequins, and we just glued them on. Makes a beautiful, beautiful Christmas card. She's got the inside all cut out. Isn't that wonderful? It's just adorable. Thank you, Angie. Next card. Oh, my pile is falling over. Let me move these a little bit. There's so many cards. Next card is a Jennifer card, too. This one, it was just simple. And the night before the party, she was a little bit nervous and anxious, and so she had some time and made this. It's just simple, piece of paper on the front and stamped on the inside, be still and know that I am God, which is one of my favorite verses. Really talked to me while I was in bed with my cancer treatments and that. Now, little commercial here. Amy at May Made It makes stamps. This stamp set is almost sold out. It's from Etsy. I mean, you can get it on her Etsy site or go to May Made It. And she made a card with this. She gave me this stamp set. Don't you love it? She gave me the stamp set because it was my birthday last week, and she gave me a stamp set for my birthday. Isn't that nice, Amy? And look at the card she made. You're going to love this. Look at this. And you know what? I still need to come in a little bit further, don't I? Look at this. And she's got it all shaded. She used a Copic marker, and she said she used the lightest shade of pink she could, and it just shaded that area. With the craft paper, it just shades it. Isn't that beautiful? That's from Amy. And also, just a word of wisdom. Whenever Amy comes out with a stamp set, buy it fast, because she sells out. Her stamps are really cute. They work very well, and they sell out very quickly. This is from Dorothy. Now, she came over to my house, and she used my machine. And this is why I had it out, because I had a bigger card. Okay. This is from Dorothy, and she used my Silhouette. And she cut all the cards out on this. Her granddaughter's favorite thing is an ice cream cone. So she made the ice cream cones. Isn't that cute? And her other granddaughter was a ladybug, so she had to love my ladybug card. And in the inside, just a simple stamp from the Stamps of Life. Sweet. Next card. Now, this card turned out to be almost impossible to make. And this is our typical Abby card. Looks so simple. She's got a black envelope for us. Doesn't that look simple? Now, I don't know whether I can get this in close enough for you to see. But see this? It's purple. And there is tulle on the top of it, which makes it look like a fishnet. And we had to take and put the fishnet over a piece of paper. And let me tell you, that is not easy. It is very difficult to put fishnet on paper and not have it look, you know, not have it where you can see through and not have edges and have it stretched properly all the way across without having lines in there. So it took us forever, and the jokes really got rough then on that, because we, at any rate, we won't go there. And then, of course, she had a beautiful stamped front on here, and we put some bling on it. It's puffed up. And she put the little, she used the little circles, you know, the foam tape in little circles. And then she had the inside stamped Happy Anniversary. Isn't that a beautiful card? And, I mean, it's only a couple pieces. It looks so simple, and this took us a long time to make just to get that tool on that card. Now, this is from my friend Anita, and I love this card. She got it off of Pinterest also, and it's so simple and beautiful looking. This is a Close to My Heart stamp, Thinking of You. Look at how beautiful that is. And look at the green on green and white. It's just awesome. And the inside, she put the little flower in there also. Doesn't that look gorgeous? I'm telling you, these card parties are unbelievable. And I saved this one for last. Laura showed up late at the card party. The reason being is she was still working on this card. Is this card gorgeous or what? This is our novice stamp maker. I mean, novice card maker 2 years ago. She's turned into an unbelievable skilled card maker and does not have any machines or anything. She does this all by hand. And look at this. This is a little bag here, so you've got a pocket here that you could put something in right here. Okay, inside of here is a little pocket where it's got a tag where you can write something on. You open up the inside and it says, some people strengthen others just by being the kind of person they are. And then it says, happy birthday. And this is also a pocket where you can insert something in, whether it be a, I don't know, a gift card or cash, whatever you want to do. But this is a birthday card also. Isn't that unbelievable? Now, I am telling you, card parties are awesome. And, oh, we give away stamp sets. That's also something you can use for prizes. Just let your imagination go wild. Last month I had, or the last card party we had, that I was the hostess, I don't know, I think we had bought a car at that time, and I put down a lot of cash on the car, and short of a little bit of cash. You know how that happens sometimes when you're budgeting and you overspend. And at any rate, I wanted to give lots of gifts because I love to get lots of gifts. Don't we all like to get a gift when we go someplace? Makes us feel wonderful. And I made composition books. I covered them. You saw them on my channel because I showed them how to make them. And I gave that. I had a couple of one of those. I've done little gift sets and whatever. We just try to do as many gifts as we can because everyone just loves getting a gift. Everyone loves the card party that comes, and the friendships have grown. We've actually gotten to the point where we know each other so well, we start out and we open our card party with prayer. And it's just so special because we know each other, we know each other's family, and we help each other out, and we're just there for each other. And it's all grown from this lovely card party, and the friendships have grown. And anyway, that's the card party, and I hope I helped you out, and I hope you do, please, do try one, even if you only have four people at the card party. And I've done one where I had four people at the card party, my two granddaughters, and my daughter and myself. And then I also had one with three people at the card party, with my two grandsons and myself. And we had a wonderful, wonderful time. I'm going to swing this out again. I will get these up on box.net, where all you have to do is click here and it'll take you over there, and you don't have to worry about anything, and you can just pull that right off. You can edit, do whatever you want. But get yourself some invitations and then some backing up, accepting them, etc., etc. Keep your rules, though. Don't let someone bring someone at the last minute because you don't have enough cards. You can't call someone up 3 days at a time and say, oh, I need you to make an extra card for everybody. It doesn't work that way. Once you're accepted, you're expected to be there, turn in your cards, and make sure, follow up with your ladies. And you don't have to be mean about it, you just got to be nice about it, and remind them, all you have to do is turn in your cards, and you are guaranteed to get a card from everyone there. My first couple of parties I made, I have to be honest with you, still in the habit of making extra cards. I do that because I'm afraid if someone doesn't get there, and we don't have their cards. Like this particular time, we had two people that hadn't turned in their cards yet. I had extra cards made to cover so that everyone walked out of there, because in here, I guarantee them they're going to walk out of here with 16 cards because we had 8 people. And I make sure that there's 16 cards. So if I had guaranteed 7 people and I had everyone's cards except one person, I would have made an extra 2 cards just to make sure that everyone got their 14 cards. See what I'm saying? You have a blessed day. Go out, plan your party, invite your friends, and have a wonderful, wonderful time. Miss you guys. I'll get posting more stuff, and I can't wait to share what I make with my new Cricut Explorer, and I just enjoy you. And thank you for stopping by. Bye now.